Hey everybody, I'm Carlos Rodella and here's what's happening. This week, Google finally announced the specs of Google Glass. The augmented reality headset will feature 16 gigs of storage, all-day battery life, and a 720p video camera. Not included in the box? The display on the left. The Oregon House has voted to prohibit employers from requiring employees or job applicants to provide login information for their Facebook accounts. The bill would also prohibit bosses from requiring employees to like their posts. Finally, you can tell your creepy boss Steve you don't want to see any more Speedo pics from when he's in Barcelona. It's creepy. Intel's first quarter profits fell 25% as the chipmaker continued to suffer from declining demand for PCs. To which PC user Terry responded, "Dude, crisis." Xerox is introducing a new way to build computers with its Zero Graphic Microassembly process, which breaks down the silicone chip into thousands of tiny chiplets, and then assembles them with an advanced 3D printing machine. Okay, quick note to Xerox. If you're going to spend money on making chiplet technology and advanced 3D printing machines, can you first fix the ones you already made? I have a print job that's been in progress for like 3 years. It's like a totally important print. Like, I really need it. News has leaked about the upcoming sequel to Microsoft's Windows 8 operating system, and the codename for it is Windows Blue. The update is said to allow users to skip the Metro-style interface altogether and boot directly to your desktop. Someone not too excited about this feature? The guy who worked really hard on the Metro interface. Aw, oh, he's so sad. And now the report on the rumored Microsoft Watch, our very own John Phillips. John?
Carlos? Early this week, news broke that Microsoft is exploring the development of a touch-enabled smartwatch. Yes, more Microsoft hardware. Apparently, Steve Ballmer wants to build on the runaway sales momentum of the Surface tablets. Now, before we get too excited about the possibility of a Surface watch, let's first recall a timepiece called the Paparazzi. Announced in 2004, this was Microsoft's original smartwatch, and its public reception was weak. Pretty much what you'd expect from wrist fashion that looked only slightly more sophisticated than a collector's set of silly bands. Designed by Swatch, the Paparazzi was promoted by a Microsoft executive who's no longer relevant, along with help from a Hollywood starlet who no longer has a career. Remember Misha Barton? Amanda Bynes even gets more press, and all she has to do is curl up in a fetal position on the floor of her gym. The Paparazzi also relied on data connectivity from a Microsoft service that no longer exists. Does anyone remember MSN Direct? It sent streaming news updates to the watch over FM radio. In 2013, that's like getting your satellite TV signal over a rooftop antenna made out of wood. Now, just because the Paparazzi was a fail, that doesn't mean the next Microsoft smartwatch will fail as well. Luxury watch buyers generally flock to brands with proven track records for sophisticated design, and if Microsoft has proven anything over the last 20 years, it's that it has a proven track record for sophisticated design. Remember Clippy?
Thanks, John.
No, thank you.
Twitter is reportedly talking with NBC about a deal that would add their network video content to tweets, because it's just what we need out of a microblogging service. Links to 2-hour episodes of Celebrity Apprentice. Hashtag you're fired. Facebook recently launched a series of TV ads, one of them showing a guy ignoring his boss using Facebook Home. Now, while this worked out for him, the guy he was ignoring was Mark Zuckerberg, who probably had no problem because it was their software. However, I think there should be this disclaimer. Do not use Facebook Home in meetings at your workplace if you value your job. I mean, with the economy the way it is, it's not safe. And finally, the company iLim are working on a bionic hand that would be controlled with your iPhone and functions with a corresponding iOS app called BioSim. iLim didn't comment on what would happen if you accidentally deleted the app on your phone, but my bet is you'd have a rogue hand on your hands. No? Try another one? Things would most definitely get out of hand. No, not that one either. On one hand, it would suck. On the other hand, well, you wouldn't have another hand. So that joke doesn't work either. Wouldn't be able to get handsy on your next date, would ya? One hand down. Hand down, man down? Anything? None of these are working. Oh.